No, I'm just, I don't know. Oh, actually, I imagine this will work. What's he doing? Look how big he is.
Right,
at least
you got the
corrosion
before and then after.
I think he's sick. Dark color to hiding in the moss.
Southern toad. Put the oyster shells and stuff in there.
Yeah, that's for dinner.
Sumter. What's that? Hey, Andrew, is that? The albino turtle, is that what you said that was?
There's a skin flow.
Yeah.
I think he might be done. He moved his feathers back up.
Yeah.
You already dropped
him
and you missed
it. You gotta get those. Andrew screwed the crap out of him.
I screwed the crap out of him.
I wish you should do that again. Now I turned my camera off, he did it.
Top is off.
Look at that tail. The color's
on him. Mahi-mahi.
That's a mahi-mahi.
Uh-huh. They got like three or four different names. Dolphin, mahi-mahi, and I think wahoo, square looking. No, wahoo are different, my bad. Wahoo look like barracuda kind. It's a big old redfish.
See, there's
a
tarpon
right
in there.
Oh.
That's the good one.
That redfish. Holy cow. That thing is enormous. All those legs. Those are like 3 feet.
There's the big shark
in the front. On the back?
Next.
I think those are jackfish. Is
it albino that way? Behind
there's
is one
the
of them.
Oh, wow.
There's another
one. There's
two divers.
The
second diver
one,
you see
the others. Yeah. Where's the other diver I've always seen?
I think it's Jack.
That'd be hilarious if he
got the prison for his rival, man.
He's the warden.
Yeah.
Hey, look at him like one.
He is feeding. It's a popular job.
He does
that.
I
counted them?
Yes.
Are they big?
They're pretty small, but I wonder if it's like this, you know, seasonal.
They're like lemmings.
I see
that. You know,
that's
okay. You can walk. Six and a half. You don't get him back.
Where
did he go?
Over there.
It's confusing.
Don't push you guys.
That thing was huge. I don't think about it.
Come back and do something, man. That's so cool. A little longer. Yes.
Questions about anything while we wait, ask away. We will try to answer them for you. Special events, that sort of thing. A forage cap or fatigue hat they would wear, like on regular duty, around and about. Often called the kepi, which is the French word for cap.
Boo.
The insignia on the caps. This horn-looking thing is a French infantry, which was a symbol of the United States infantry. After the Civil War, they went to the cross, muskets and rifles on it. The C tells us he's in Company C of the 13th Regiment of the Infantry, regular United States Army. You can see the B in the 25th, down there. Also notice how this man has almost called a frock coat, how much longer it is. This is for more formal, regular army wear. This is for out in the field. It's called a four-button or a sack coat, the shorter coat. So like in field operations when you're out and about. Or maybe fatigue duty. You folks need a belt marking the 142nd anniversary of the beginning of the war. Down south, it's the war. War between the states. Folks up north and out west, primarily known as the Civil War. The lateness, a little more genteel fashion. We have a garrison here of the United States Forces, representing the garrison that would have been here on April 12, 1861, even though it was an all-artillery garrison here at the time. We can't fire the big guns. When this program's over with, if you want to go over in where the gun crew is, they'll give a demonstration on talk on the big guns, how they were serviced, aimed, loaded, fired, that sort of thing. But in the American Civil War, 600 and... Shoulder, arm. From this position, the soldier has 9-point count to load and fire his musket. The first command would be, load, and 9 times, load. Weapons brought down off the shoulder, placed in front. The soldier reaches over to his right side to his cartridge box, where he carries 40 rounds of ammunition. Bullet wrapped up in a piece of paper with charge. Notice how everything is going to be done from essentially the right side. Next command, handle cartridge. Call out that cartridge with the bullet and paper, or the powder and the bullet wrapped up in the paper. Bring the cartridge up to his mouth and bites it with his front teeth. Next command, tear cartridge. Tear the paper off to expose the bullet and powder for loading. If you did not want to be drafted during the American Civil War, we had our first national draft at that time, you would simply go down to your local dentist and have him pull out all your front teeth. If you have no front teeth, you can't tear the cartridge over the bucket, and you are exempt from service.
That means your mom couldn't have been in the
army. Some men went to Canada to avoid the draft. An old American tradition. To avoid military service, go to Canada. Next command, charge cartridge. This means you pour all the powder down the barrel. We will remove the bullet from the paper. We were firing a bullet. This is just blanks, just like in the movies. Just blanks. No real bullet. Pour the powder down the barrel. Remove the bullet from the paper. Place it in the muzzle. Next command, draw primer. We now have to push the bullet, which is up here in the muzzle, all the way down to the end of the barrel. So the command is ram cartridge. Sink the bullet in on top of the paper, on top of the powder charge. Next command, return primer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we just have to get on the other side and shoot this way.
Weapons brought up in this fashion, and a percussion cap is pulled over a little extension at the end of the barrel called a cone. Inside that cone, a passageway which leads into the breech where the power is. Just like firing a cap pistol. Pull the trigger on a cap pistol, the hammer comes down, strikes the cap, pop, and makes a spark. Same thing. When the command fire is given, the hammer comes down, strikes the percussion cap, shoots a spark into the breech where the gun fires. The weapons are now loaded, so the men will now about face. We won't shoot at you folks today. It's a special observance program. Now, we're preparing to fire the weapons. The final commands are ready, aim, fire. So if you want to watch your ears, the time to do so is soon be upon us. So moms and dads with the little ones, you think it's important for them to watch their ears? Perform fine. If you're wearing a hearing device, you may want to turn it down a little bit. This is a great big, we're not shooting a cannon here, but it's all that makes a noise. Now, we don't have any four-legged pets with us today. But ladies, it's with you. That husband, that boyfriend, we don't want to scare your pet and have him go running away back to the boat and scare him when his gun goes off. So you ladies control your pets.
Ready!
To put holes straight through the ship.
Come together. Mm-hmm. That's the Cooper.
That's the Cooper.
That's the Atlantic, and the Ashley's over there.
That's the Ashley.
Ashley, and Cooper, and the Atlantic.
Isn't it nice that you don't have like the little barracks and stuff?
Yeah.
That's nice. That over there talks about the USS Henry.
Oh, the submarine?
That's the LA lay the mines there. It's like an early video game.
So let's say 100 PDR? 100 pounder?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's a big piece of sausage. I still can't figure out why they're just shooting into the wall. Paul, you took botany. I know that for a fact.
Yeah, I do.
I know about chlorophyll. That's about it.
Photosynthesis.
Yeah.
Want to
take a salad? Not holding back.
Yeah. I have downward
dog. Yeah, I really like downward dog, Trey.
I've never seen it.
Well, see, he's paddling, so he has his feet out of the water.
Is he relaxing?
He's relaxing, so he has his feet out.
Wait, can you show us downward dog?
Yeah, I can. I'm not here.
Is that anything like deputy dog?
I'm not here. They're picking up a nice letter.
Oh, it's 15 and 16. Oh, 15, one way and 16.
Yeah. What
are they? Well, that was... 15 is Cypress Lake and 16 is the Woods Walk.
What's up, my brother?
So this is Cypress Lake.
How do you get to the other side?
Here, that's
it. Can you go around?
We're surrounded by...
This is so pretty.
I love you, sweetie. That's what I was wondering.
That is an alligator, dude.
Where?
Floating out in the middle?
That's an alligator, shit. Out in the middle?
Yeah. It is.
I'm zooming for that bad boy.
you. I've never seen a real alligator before outside of the cage. It's kind of creepy.
Creepy.
That's me. What do I see this?
Cypress, that's what I was trying to come from.
Yeah.
Behind you, there.
Bastard!
That was a spray. That's a query,
I think it's still there. I think it's still there. I think it's
still there. I think it's still there. I think
those people.
Oh, they're all there?
Really? What am I stinking there?
I think it's cute. Very.
Which way are we gonna walk?
Unless it's a log.
What's moving?
Alligator somewhere.
Yeah, I think that's it.
Oh, yeah.
Trying to get under this branch here. It requires some.
Yeah.
Oh, how you doing, Sure? That hurts.
You
didn't film it, did you?
Oh, no.
No, sir.
Yeah, get closer and go, look at this beauty. So little. That's for the earthquakes, and they screw the house back after it.
having a...
There's
a thing. Yeah. Let
me see you guys play. I'm a great society member. Well, in that nature, like, it's stuffed peacock. Ooh. And they had it up on a pedestal for it to get up high. And then the bottom here, and the bed is all the way down. It was, I mean, I would never do it, but it was absolutely worth it.
Come on, do it again.
Well, I don't know that that's the women.
All right. Come on, Steve Irwin. Why do I see Bob Saget making commentary on this video in about 3 months? Here's a little, oh, wow.
My apartment.
Ooh, look, you can get deer horns.
I wonder what they did over there.
No, that's the,
sure, the slave owner got it on with.
Oh, maybe we don't. That's true, maybe we don't have any intro. For me.
That's neat.
Stop it.
Maybe you can get some hearing aids.
You know that Milcro Gear 2000? This is for close range.
Fort Sumter way out there.
Hello, Fort Sumter.
This one doesn't have the funny front door.
Somewhere, isn't it? Picture on there. Oh yeah, that's great. Two eyes is on this.
This is not supposed to have any right angles in it.
All this furniture, this is not
the another pink edifice. Pounded. The whole cemetery. So this is the big street, huh?
It's a lot.
It's where your SNOB or SOB? Super Nintendo Chalmers.
Get it
on that go. Let's do it.
That's if we can, but we'll try. Oldest on the floor. Pretty freaking old.
Oldest theater in the country? Yeah. This is cool. Where'd y'all sit?
We usually have the middle.
What else did you see?
haven't been for a while.
Rainbow Row.
Yeah.
So why is it called Rainbow Row?
Because it's where the slaves came to buy stuff and they couldn't read, so they had the different buildings painted all different colors so that they wouldn't know which building was what.
I thought the team was at the stock market today. They rang the opening bell.
They were?
Yeah. They had
I'd call that lavender. Not near as much old stuff.
Right.